recent news articles that you probably are well aware of. The first was at the end of April, the United Methodist Church held their 11-day general conference in Charlotte, North Carolina. And it was during this conference that the delegates voted 692-51 in favor of changing the church's policy towards ordaining LGBTQ people and performing same-sex marriages. In one of the follow-up interviews that I watched, several of the delegates were celebrating the decision and were quoted as saying that the Apostle Paul was just wrong on this issue, that the Bible was wrong. That's extremely dangerous language because Romans chapter 1, the Apostle Paul wasn't making a comment on society. He was stating the natural law of God. In Romans chapter 1, verse 18 and 19, we read, "For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who by their unrighteousness suppress the truth. For what can be known about God is plain to them, because God has shown it to them." And then he continues in verse 24 and 25, "Therefore God gave them up in the lusts of their heart to impurity, to the dishonoring of their bodies among themselves, because they exchanged the truth about God for a lie and worshipped and served the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen." What the United Methodist Church has done is to vote that a portion of the scripture is wrong and no longer relevant. In their words, they say the Bible is filled with hate speech or hateful language. The problem is that when you remove one part of scripture that you don't agree with, what's to stop you from removing more that no longer are deemed relevant for our society or agreeable to our culture? Revelation 22 has a very clear warning against taking away portions of the Word of God. That brings me to my second, the second news article that was reported this week. The Kansas City Chiefs kicker, Harrison Butker, speaking boldly at the Benedictine College where he delivered the commencement address to the students. And it's been well publicized that he spoke out against the celebration of sin that is called Pride Month. Butker was unapologetical and bold as he stated, "Our Catholic faith has always been countercultural. Our Lord, along with countless others, were all put to death for their adherence to her teachings. The world around us says that we should keep our beliefs to ourselves whenever we go against the tyranny of diversity, equity, and inclusion. We are speaking truth because now, unfortunately, truth is in the minority." And he went on to say, "These are the sort of things we are told to, in polite society, to not to bring up. You know, the difficult and unpleasant things. But if we're going to be men and women for this time in history, we need to stop pretending that the Church of Nice is a winning proposition. We must always speak and act in charity, but never mistake charity for cowardice." That's courage on display. One man speaking the truth when an entire denomination seems incapable of doing so. But that one man is the majority. Even if you're only one person speaking God's truth today against a billion others who disagree with you, remember you are in the majority. You and the Creator of the universe will always be the majority in the room. Will you be courageous today to stand for God's truth? God bless you, and I look forward to seeing you on Sunday morning as we worship together.